Whether you're aware of it or not, every one of us has an effect on those around us, and we all have a responsibility to support our soldiers, our mission, and each other with a positive attitude.
Ranger! Airborne! Hi-ya! Hi-ya!
Barbie! That energy that you bring to work every day is what I'm looking for you to pass that heat through your feet down to the NCOs below you, okay?
Every day, everyone at Fort Benning has the opportunity to interact with each other and to be a leader, and that every day that they, and every chance that they see each other, they can be an inspirational leader.
Cover down on the standards, kind of get everybody on the same sheet of music. You know, get the team pulling together in the same direction with the same energy, with the same goals and end state.
Major General Ferreter and Command Sergeant Major Rice are doing all they can to get the message out and encourage all of us here at Fort Benning to be positive, inspirational leaders to the troops and each other.
It's something inside you that when you get up in the morning, you say, today I got a chance to deal with the best soldiers in the world, the American soldier. Now, either a comrade of my same rank, or a youngster that I'm going to be training, or I'm a civilian who works here at Fort Benning, and I have a chance to touch someone today and be an inspirational leader.
Inspirational leadership is not just about the power of positive thinking, it's about the influence of positive doing.
Positive mental attitude and infectious leadership, inspirational leadership, it's contagious. And a team that's working together, who believe in each other, believe in what they're doing, and passing that along, it gets infectious, and that allows Fort Benning to operate that much more smoothly. At the other end of the phone, across the counter, at the training site, that switched on, yeah, I get it, and we're gonna go after it. That's exactly the infectious nature of positive leadership.
In order for the U.S. Army to continue being the strong, well-oiled freedom fighting machine, we must all fuel it and ourselves with enthusiasm and a can-do attitude.
We have to produce the best soldiers in the world. In order to do that, you got to have that motivated, that inspirational leader who can provide that soldier that purpose, direction, and motivation to be able to accomplish those tasks and goals that you need them to get after.
General Ferreter and Sergeant Major Rice are setting the standard and leading the way in this noble effort by inspiring from the front.
If I'm asking you to do it, you can expect that I'll live the same standard. If they can see that we're doing it, then they understand that this is a lifelong commitment, that they understand that of course it's safe, and also that they look up and they say, that's Sergeant Major does that. I think there's something good about what we do here. I think maybe this is the profession that I want to do.
So spread the word and be a positive force to those soldiers and civilians around you. Set the example and encourage others to do the same.
There are great things that are done that go unseen. And so to everyone out there, I would say, you know, find the opportunity to reward outstanding performance and find the opportunity to thank people who serve our country, serve the nation, and serve within the Army or support those of us in uniform, because this is a very important time.
From the drill sergeants to the AFES clerks, it's imperative that every one of us continue our commitment to excellence here at Fort Benning and continue to make it the best military installation on the planet and provide the operational Army with only the finest soldiers in the world.